Celom desni tešitelju duši istine, izvrde si sve ispunjavanje sokrovišu blagih i žizni podatelju, pridi u sedice u njim i očisti nje od svake skveni i spasi blaža duši naše. Slava Otcu i Sinu i Svetomu Duhu, nije Hrista u vijek i oko amin. Gospodi pomili, Gospodi pomili, Gospodi pomili.
Molite vam se, Otcu našeg Gospodi, Svetomu Hrista Bože naše.
Amin.
Pomaž Bog, brate i sestre, dragi otče. Dragi otče. Velika mi je čast da pozdravim večerašnje gosta naših razgovora o veri protosinđela Serafima Petkovića, koji nam dolazi iz manastira Svete Trojice i iz Bijelih voda kod Ljubovije. Ovaj manastir pripada Šabačkoj eparhiji, pa nam otac donosi i blagoslov vladike Lavrentija, koji je svojevremeno bio episkop zapadnoevropske eparhije, i koja je tada obuhvatala i Veliku Britaniju. Manastir Svete Trojice je relativno nov manastir, čiji je osnivač Ktitor Karađorđe Ristanović, podigao manastir na imanju svojih roditelja, a otac Serafim je došao na osvećenje toga manastira i ostao tamo. Otac je rođen u Beogradu, u zgradi pored kafane Znaka pitanja, i u kojoj je bila prva pošta i prva srpska apoteka. Verovatno nije slučajno se danas otac bavi duhovnim lekovima, duhovni apotekar, ali i poštar koji šalje duhovne poruke. Otac je završio tehničku fiziku na elektrotehničkom fakultetu i radio kao istraživač i diplomirani inženjer u institutu
Mihajlo Pupin u Beogradu.
Iako je odrastao u neposrednoj blizini Saborne crkve i igrao se u porti crkve, to još nije označilo početak njegovog crkvenog života. Gospod ga je dotakao kada je kao nekršten došao u crkvu kao pojac, jer je lepo pevao. Još uvek lepo pevao. Ono što ga je najviše podstaklo da se odluči na krštenje u svojoj 33. godini, bilo je čitanje Svetog pisma, a potom i žitije Svetog Saveća, zaštitnika naše parohije kome je ovaj dan posvećen. Krstio se u manastiru Vavidenje zajedno sa čerkom Milenom, a krstnik je vladika jer je monah tadašnji Atanasije Jeftić. Pre krštenja je postao 42 dana na vodi jer nije znao da ne mora. A kako kaže, posle krštenja 7 dana mu nije silazio osmeh sa lica. Kao bračan čovjek otac troje dece posle raspada porodice u Kanadi u kojoj je živeo nekoliko godina, odlučio je da se zamonaši. Definitivnu odluku da se zamonaši donosi posle hodočašća u svetu zemlju. Sačekavši da deca dovoljno odrastu, prima monaški postrig u Grčkoj crkvi, u Njujorku. Potom je jedno vreme živo u Grčkoj, dok ga je vladika Lavrentije nije pozvao da dođe u Šabačkoj eparhiji. U početku je otac bio sam u manastiru Svete Trojice, ali danas se bratstvo umnožilo, a osim toga i mnoštvo posetilaca duhovne dece i duhovno gladnih dolazi kod oca da ih otac posavete i olakša im teško breme i približi Bogu kroz iskreno pokajanje i ispovest. To je tema večerašnjeg predavanja, pa ćemo uskoro čuti više o ovoj svetoj tajni. U manastiru se danas na jelosvećenju dešavaju mnoga čuda i iseljenja. Također u manastiru se i neke ikone mirotočile, a i sam kivot u kojem je odežda Svete Petke. Otac je pokrenuo izdavaštvo duhovne literature. Sa ostalim Serafimom doputovao je brat Branko Trijić. Tu, Branko.
Jeste, tu.
Koji svira gitaru i njih dvoje zajedno sa Zoranom Ivkovićem i Nelom Popovićem čine sastav Srpče.
Nelo Sudal, sad je Krgović, u početku je bila Popović.
Otac Serafim i brat Branko izvešli jednu tačku program koje je organizovalo kolo srpskih sestara ove subote. Na početku imamo 3 sata posle podne u velikoj sali. A u nedelju 1. marta pozdravili izvešće koncert u našem hramu odmah posle liturgije, što je prilike oko podne. Otac je pokrenuo i izdavaštvo duhovne literature u manastiru. Mnogima od vas je poznata knjiga u 5 nastavaka otcu Flavijanu, autora ruskog sveštenika otca Aleksandra Torika, koji je stvorio ovaj lik na osnovi iskustava raznih sveštenika i poznanstava sa njima kao model jednog dobrog pastira. Kada je otac Aleksandar upoznao sa Serafima prilikom predstavljanja njegove knjige u Srbiji, rekao, evo, našao sam jednog Flavijana. Komplet ovih knjiga, kao i diskovi sastava Srpče, možete nabaviti ovde posle predavanja u Velikoj sali. Sav prihod od prodaje ide manastiru Svete Trojice za kupovinu zemljišta pored manastira i izgradnju konaka na tom zemljištu da bi manastir mogao da primi i ugosti još više posetilaca. Više o tome i kako pomoći manastiru možete naći u onim mestima koje smo ostavili na stolicama, koje smo oštampali. Oče Serafime i brate Branko, dobro je nam došli. Hvala vam što ste se odazvali našem pozivu, naše duhovne zajednice Svete Galipije Stolpnika u Londonu, pri ovoj parohiji. Molimo se, Gospodu, da nam vaše predavanje večeras ne bude jedino i da nam opet dođete u posjetu. Blagoslovi, Oče.
Bog nas sve blagoslovi, da se bude slavu Boga. Hristos vaskrese! Radosti naše. Evo, braći i sestre, hvala vam i na pozivu i na ovako lepom dočeku i lepim rečima. Ja ću još malo dodati, evo sad gledate slike iz naših manastira. Evo kad padne sneg, to je naša crkva. U početku je bio napravljen samo crkva i mali konak.
Samo malo je crkva.
Da, malo.
Jel se sad čuje?
Sad čujem.
Znači, u početku je bila nečes.
Probajte ovaj.
Da, možete bolje tako.
Hoće. Pokušajte sam ovaj...
Jedan. Dobro, bit će bolje ovako nešto. Znači, u početku je napravljena crkva i mali konak. Manastir je bio zamišljen kao mesto odmora za vladiku Lavrentija, pošto je on obično bio na Sokogradu i kad se tamo skupi gužva i pošto on voli da piše i nekada se povuče, onda je brat Karadžić Đeristanović napravio taj manastir i ponudio njemu da mu to bude tako mesto da negde da se malo skloni, da se odmori. Međutim, vladika je mene pozvao, pošto on već pripremao jedno drugo mesto za svoj odmor, i ponudio mi da dođem na osvećenje malog konaka, u kome je bila samo jedna kelija, jedna trpezarija, jedan salon. I ja sam došao i meni se dopalo i tako sam ostao u tom manastiru.
Mi smo... Da provodim.
A da.
Neću moći da se setim.
Oprosti.
Možete jače oči, ja čujem.
Is there anyone here that can't understand something, yeah? So the monastery of the Holy Trinity was founded u kojoj godini?
2005.
At the end. Yeah, in 2005, the land was actually donated by a layperson by the name of
Karađorđe
Ristanović, and it was the local bishop Lavrentije which actually called Father to come and to start a monastery on this location.
That's it. Mi smo, kad sam počeo, bio sam sam, ali kad, čim je došao jedan monah, već smo ustanovili, bili svetogorski tipik, imali smo sve molitve koje imaju na Hilandaru, od polunoćnice, pa svaki dan liturgiju i uveče, deveti čas povečer je i večernju službu.
So when he commenced, when he started the monastery, it was only himself. But then quite quickly he was joined by another brother or multiple brothers.
Another novice.
And they commenced life according to the same life cycle as is found on Mount Athos.
After a while, a lot of people started to come and we had a need to make a new konak.
So a new living quarters for the monastics.
Pobrko jezike. I pošto smo to radili tako iz malih priloga i stalnih putovanja, tako smo počeli da putujemo u Belorusiju, Rusiju, Švajcarsku, Austriju, da posećamo naše parohije i da malo propovedamo, da pevamo naše pesme i tako smo skupljali prilike i skoro nam je trebalo 9 godina da završimo konak koji ima oko 600 kvadrata.
So he started gradually visiting various countries including Russia and Belorussia in order to raise money to build the various buildings that are now found on the site of the monastery including the living quarters themselves.
Taj konak je predviđen za monaštvo, međutim sada, pošto nemamo drugi, onda tu primamo i goste i monaštvo i to je malo teška situacija.
So the living quarters were intended purely for monastics, but because they didn't have more space, actually lay people, when they come to visit, they also stay in the same building.
I sada smo dobili priliku da otkupimo imanje pored manastira u kome ima tri zgrade.
So now the opportunity has arisen to actually buy land which is adjacent to the monastery.
Ima 2 hektara zemlje, ima nešto šume, ima jedan šljivik od stotinak šljiva i ima tri zgrade od kojih jedna može da bude konak za goste.
So there are 3 buildings on this adjacent piece of land, one of which can be living quarters for guests. And in addition to this, there is also an orchard with plums and some woodland.
Okay. Ova druga zgrada treba da postane trpezarija isto za goste i treća isto možda bude konak. Ona je gotovo spremna za upotrebu, ali ove dve treba i da se, što kaže, završe i da se stave u funkciju.
So, yeah, one of the buildings can be used for guests, and the other 2 buildings, quite a lot of work remains to actually put them into use.
Mi smo tako i došli, mi smo zamolili onda našeg vladiku da nam da dozvolu da uđemo u otkup toga imanja, tih građevina.
So we asked the bishop to give us his blessing to begin negotiations in an attempt to buy this land.
I dobili smo.
Which we received.
I započeli smo jednu akciju kod nas, već slično kao što smo ovde napisali u ovim papirićima, i uspeli smo da skupimo oko 180 naših ljudi koji učestvuju u toj akciji, koji svakoga meseca uplate po jedan mali deo, da bi mi mogli da uplaćemo na svaka 3 meseca jedan deo za to imanje.
So already they have managed to find 180 regular donators who give on a monthly basis in order for them to be able to pay for the cost of the land.
To je suma oko 15 ili 16 evra.
So the monthly sum is 15 to 16 euros.
I ona bi nam zaista pomogla da ja sam već u godinama da ne moram tako mnogo da putujem i da tražim ovaj novac sa strane, a da se više posvetimo, što kaže, duhovnim stvarima, pa da i da omogućimo, znači, vama i vaše dece da dolazite kod nas i da se duhovno okrepljate.
So the aim is to get more people that will be donating on a monthly basis in order to avoid the need for father to have to actually travel to many various locations, as is the case today, to raise the money, but to be able to do it in a more steady and predictable manner.
Svaka vaša lepta biće dobro došla i, što kaže, ko crkvi daju, Bogu pozajmljuje, a onda se mi molimo da Gospod vrati vama po vašoj ljubavi.
So every pound is welcome, and everything that you give to God will be returned, and you will be also remembered in the monastery's prayers.
Oprostite što smo ovo odmah na početku tako počeli, ali posle ćemo govoriti o ovoj temi, pa ćete moći da postavite pitanja, da ne bi se to mešali jedno i drugo. Tako smo sad uradili.
Forgive me for starting with money, but I wanted to get that out of the way. And now we are going to talk about a completely different topic.
Ovo je naš starac Simon.
This is our elder Simeon.
He was, on je ovaj starac koji je bio dugo godina u Studenici, manastiru Studenica.
Many years he was in the monastery of Studenica.
Jedno vreme u ispostnici Svetoga Save.
And at one point in the remote location, ispostnica. Skit of Saint Sava.
Više o tome će biti na koncertu, ćemo objašnjavati pre svake pesme kako je nastala. Mnoge od tih reči je napisao otac Simon. Izdao je tri knjige, Monaška brojanica, pesama. I tako smo mi nekako i počeli. Sredi smo se na putu za starca Tadeja, a onda posle 20 kusur godina smo počeli oko tih pesama i tako je ovo sve pokrenuto.
So many of the songs which you will be able to hear at the concert on Sunday were actually written by monk Simeon.
Okay. Večeras pričamo o pokajanju.
Tonight we will talk about repentance.
Evo, približava se časni post. I to je zaista vreme koje je pogodno da se malo preslišamo.
So the great fast is approaching, and so this is a very opportune moment to talk about this topic.
Zato što se naša čula izoštre za vreme posta.
Because our senses are more heightened and alert during the time of the great fast.
Svi smo mi ljudi grešni i nema bezgrešnoga osim jednoga Gospoda. I zaista ne bi bilo ni spasenja da Gospod po svojoj ljubavi i milosti nije nam dao on svetu tajnu ispovesti, svetu tajnu pokajanja.
We all sinners apart from the Lord, and we wouldn't even be able to attain salvation if we didn't have the holy mystery of repentance.
Pokajanje se sastoji iz tri faze. Prva faza je da umom shvatimo gde grešimo i prema Gospodu i prema bližnjima.
repentance consists of three different
phases.
Elements, yes. And the first one is to mentally accept.
To
acknowledge that we have sinned. Yeah.
Yeah. To Lord and to thy neighbor. Drugo, u srcu da se iskreno pokajemo, a to znači da ustanemo protiv greha i protiv đavola.
And then to repent within the heart, which means to war against the devil and to war against sin.
I treća faza je da ispovedimo pred sveštenikom bez ulepšavanja i bez samoopravdavanja.
And the third phase is to then declare these to confess these sins in front of a priest and without making excuses for ourselves and without trying to somehow make the sin lighter than it really is.
Dok je greh u nama, on onda radi. Znači, zato je važno da ga osvetlimo. Kad se osvetli, kada se ispovedi, on gubi svoju snagu.
So while the sin is within us, it is active, but once we confess it, then it loses its power.
Na primjer, znači čovjek koji se boji da ispovedi, znači on će lako će slagati da se ne bi pokazao taj greh. Ubica će ponovo ubiti da bi sakrio ubistvo i tako dalje. Preljubnik će ponovo preljubiti. Znači dogodi je greh u nama, a sa druge strane...
So he who is afraid to confess, he will, a liar will repeat his lie, and a murderer will murder again.
To je brvno u našim očima koje Gospod pominje u Svetom Evanđelju kad kaže zašto vidiš trunu u oku brata svoga, a brno u svome ne vidiš.
So that is the log within the eye that is talked about in the Bible. So when the Lord says, why do you see the log within the eye of your brother, but you do not see it within yourself?
Mi smo vrlo skloni da uvek gledamo preko puta.
We are very prone to looking at others and outside of us.
I tu da tražimo rešenje, da mislimo da nam neko drugi smeta i da zato padamo u razne grehe i razne stanje.
So we are very prone to looking outside of us and to also thinking that it is our neighbor who is to blame for that which is happening to us.
Ali u stvari mi dok se ne očistimo od greha, mi gledamo kroz to brvno i onda sve pogrešno vidimo.
And until we cleanse ourselves of sin, then we are seeing this this log in our neighbor's eyes and we see everything mistakenly.
Mnogim ljudima je jako neprijatno da dođu na ispovest i smatraju da to nešto jako mučno.
So many people find it very discomforting to go to confession. It's something very difficult to them.
A u stvari je potpuno suprotno. Čovjek se, znači, kad se pokaje, kad se ispovedi, on se oslobodi.
But actually it should be the opposite. So when a person confesses, they're actually freeing themselves.
Naravno, bez tog iskrenog pokajanja u nama, bez tog shvatanja da smo ponovo Gospodu zarili nove klince u stare rane, a to je to što mi činimo kad se oklonimo grehu.
So without repentance, we are actually nailing new nails into Christ. This is what we are doing when we continue to sin.
Without that, if we just talk about our sins, they won't be forgiven.
Ako, čuli ste
srpski. Da. Oprostite.
Ja, mene se kuni.
Da. Zato što Gospod stoji pored sveštenika i gleda naša srca, i ako mi u srcima nismo se zaista okrenuli i ustali, onda ti gresi ne moraju da budu oprošteni. Čak i ako pročitamo molitvu.
So the mere declaration of the sin to the priest, if it is not actually coming from the heart, do not assume that it will be forgiven by the Lord.
Kad nam je greh oprošten, kad smo zaista ustali svom svojom snagom protiv greha i protiv đavola, kad se borimo svom svojom snagom i svim što imamo, kad se borimo protiv greha, ako tako i upadnemo ponovo u greh, ponovo će nam Gospod oprostiti.
So the Lord will help us when we are fighting with all our might against sin, and even if we fall again, he will help us.
Imaju ljudi koji nisu sigurni da su im gresi oprošteni, pa onda idu od jednog do drugog sveštenika ili od jednog do drugog starca i napružne što se brda i u Srbiji i u Crnoj Gori ljudima koji idu i stalno ispovedaju iste grehe.
There are many people as well who do not believe that their sins are forgiven and therefore they go from priest to priest confessing the same sins and there is many such people in Serbia that act in such a way.
And in Montenegro, and they go to the hills, to the elders like Father Joel and Father Rafaelo and the others, and asking the same questions. Kako znamo da su nam gresi oprošteni? Pa tako što ih ne ponavljamo. Ako uspemo zaista da se tako pokajemo, da promenimo naš život. Pokajanje ili metanija na grčkom znači preumljenje ili promena života.
How do we know that our sins are forgiven? It's actually if we have the if we have stopped sinning. And actually in Greek the word for repentance is
to change the way of thinking. Metanija.
Metanija, which translated literally means to change your way.
Way of thinking and way of life. So, it is not, ne treba samo da dođemo u crkvu i da izdeklamo svoje grehe i da očekujemo da nam se sad sve u životu promeni na bolje. Moramo prvo da postanemo istinski hrišćani.
So it is not enough just to come to church to confess your sins and then to expect that everything will be fine after that, but we have to truly repent and with our hearts.
Many people come. Se čuje se. Mnogi ljudi dođu i žale se kako im ništa ne ide od ruke, kako i odmah misle da im neko nešto radi, da im čara neko i brača i tako dalje.
So many people come and they complain that nothing is going their way, and in particular many people have this paranoia that someone is has cursed them or is dabbling in some kind of magic against them.
Ja ih pitam, kad ste se pričestili poslednji put?
And I ask them, when did you partake of the Holy Communion last time?
Ja kažu, ne mogu da se setim.
And they can't remember.
Ja kažu, dobro ste živi.
And he says, it's good you're still alive. Despite the fact that you haven't had communion.
Mnogi ljudi ne shvataju nekako šta je u stvari pravoslavlje i drži se nekog tradicionalnog pravoslavlja, to je da se dođe na Veliki petak, na Badnje veče, supale sveće i da se dobro najede na slavama i misle da je to pravoslavlje.
So many people don't know what orthodoxy is. They think it is enough to turn up for some of the great feasts for on Good Friday, to turn up for patron saints' days when they have an abundance of food, and they think this is orthodoxy.
Po našim kanonima kaže se ko neće da posti sredu ili petak ili neki od četiri velika posta, piše da se odluči takav od crkve.
And in fact, they don't know that according to the holy canons, it is actually written that he who does not fast on Wednesdays and Fridays, or the four fasts which the church has mandated, according to the canons, he should be excommunicated from the church.
The other, drugi kanon kaže, ko ne dođe tri puta nedeljom na liturgiju, a može da dođe, ali hoće da spava ili da igra fudbal, isto tako da se i takav odluči od crkve.
And there is another canon which also states that if you do not attend liturgy for three Sundays in a row, but okay, I don't think the canon says you can't, you're playing football, but if you play football or do something else, if you can't be bothered to come, basically, the same is mandated, so excommunication.
Suština, ako je čovjek bolestan, to je druga stvar, ali ako može da dođe, a neće, nego nešto mu je drugo važnije, onda se primenjuje taj zakon.
So it is not a matter of purely of attendance. If obviously if you are ill, then this is a completely different case, but it's a question of if you are able to and you simply choose by your own free will not to.
Sad kad bi mi uzeli primjeli te kanone, ko bi bio pravoslavan?
Who would still be orthodox if we actually acted by the canons?
Manje od 1%.
Less than 1%.
To što se nas tiče nije isto tako, nije isto kod Grka i kod Rusa, ali u principu jako mali broj ljudi zaista se drži ovih pravila.
So the numbers may be slightly different amongst Greeks and Russians compared to Serbs, but in general very few people actually are living according to these canons.
Mnoge te krilatice su prihvaćene za vreme komunističke vlasti. Jer tako smo, nažalost, svi učeni da ne valja mnogo da se ide u crkvu, da je to čim neko ide ili je mnogo grešan ili je sekta.
So this is a habit that developed during the times of communism in particular, and there is this strange attitude that he who goes to church, either he is very sinful or he belongs to a sect.
Or ili danas opet mnogi kažu neću da idem tamo. Sad su to sve bivši komunisti.
Or many people say they don't want to go to church because the ones that do go are former communists who are hypocrites.
A kad idu u kafanu, onda im ne smetaju ni komunisti, ni kriminalci. Ili u bioskop, ili na plažu. Uopšte se ne pitaju da li su tamo komunisti.
But in other areas of their leisure time, such as when they go to cafes or beach or to the cinema, then it is not a problem for them to mix with former communists.
Mnogo takvih stvari nekako prihvaćeno kroz javno mnjenje, tako da samo da se onemogući da ljudi krenu putem spasenja.
So this type of mentality is very prevalent in the in public life. And the aim is to actually dissuade people from living a church life.
Gospod nas nije stvorio da bi jeli, pili, spavali, razmnožavali se i plaćali račune.
So the Lord did not create us purely to eat, drink, sleep, procreate, and pay taxes and bills.
Svaki čovjek je stvoren po Božjem planu i snabdeven određenim talentima da izvrši određeni zadatak.
So every every man and woman is created specifically with the intent of with the Lord's intent and with certain talents to achieve certain aims.
Na krštenju se dobije anđeo čuvar koji nam pomaže i upućuje nas da bi izvršili svoju misiju.
So at the moment of the christening we receive our guardian angel who's given to us in order to help us to fulfill this mission.
Međutim, ako ne upoznamo Gospoda, ako se ne ucrkvenimo kako treba, onda ćemo tek kad posle smrti shvatiti da nam je život bio potpuno uzaludan.
So if we do not actually get to know the Lord, it is only after the moment of death that we will realize how aimless our life actually was.
Mi treba da osluškujemo šta je Božja volja i da tako nekako shvatimo šta je naša uloga u ovom životu.
We have to try and understand what is the will of the Lord and what is our actual aim and the mission that he has given us in this life.
Zato, znači, istinsko pokajanje, znači, potpuno promjena života. Znači, ono što smo...
So, true repentance is a complete change in one's life, a complete reorientation.
Potrebno je da se molimo i u domu, znači da počnemo dan sa molitvom, da završavamo.
So it is necessary at home to start the day with prayer and to finish the day with prayer.
Kako glasi prva zapovest, ljubi Gospoda Boga svog, svom dušom, svojim, svim umom, svojim srcem, svojim i svom snagom, svojim.
So what does the first commandment say? So it says, love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength.
A mi ne možemo jedno oče naš, da kažem, jedno oče naš traje pola minuta, a dan ima 1440 minuta. A mi govorimo stalno kako nema vremena.
And we are able barely even to say the Lord's Prayer, which takes about half a minute, and think about how many minutes a day has within it.
Naša borba je pre svega protiv pomisli. Kako kaže apostol Pavle, mi se ne borimo protiv tela i krvi, nego protiv duhova zlobe koji su pod nebesju.
So our struggle is primarily a mental spiritual one where we are not warring against physical enemies of flesh and blood. But against spiritual enemies.
Satan je shvatio da pomoću bluda može da pokori ceo svet.
And Satan has realized then that a way of submitting the world to him, or primarily one of the ways, is especially through the sin of fornication.
I mnogi sada padaju u to, u taj greh. Čak se smatra da je to normalno. Znači, pošto svi tako žive, misli se da je to tako normalno.
And there are many that fall into this sin. In fact, it has become something that is accepted in the public sphere as normal, and many people fall into it.
Međutim, ono što je Gospod rekao, on je rekao, nebo i zemlje će proći, a moje reči neće proći.
But the Lord said that heaven and earth have an end to them, but my words will never end.
Iako je Gospod rekao da je blud smrtni greh, on je smrtni greh, sada i uvek.
And if the Lord said that the fornication is a carnal sin, is a deadly sin, then it was a deadly sin before, and it's a deadly sin forever. It's not something temporal.
Dok sam bio u Grčkoj, grčki sveštenici mi kažu, koliko da damo mladim ljudima koji žive tako u grehu, koliko da im damo da poste pa da se pričiste.
So when father was living in Greece, one of the topics that the priest discussed was for young people that lived in such a fashion, they were discussing what is the length of fast they should give them, a period of repentance and penitence following this sin before they could partake of Holy Communion.
Ja kažem, ja tako ne pričešćujem.
And he told these priests, such people, I do not commune.
Zašto? Pa zato što je to pričešćivanje bez pokajanja.
And the simple reason is because it is partaking of Holy Communion, but without genuine repentance.
Zato što oni znaju da će ponovo opet pasti u isti greh.
Because they are repeating and know they will repeat this sin.
Onda bolje da piju samo svetu vodu.
So it's better that they just drink holy water.
Dok se stvar ne reši. A rešit će se tako ili veritba ili ženitba.
Until the situation is resolved, and the way it will be resolved is through marriage.
Ja objašnjam tako slikovito mladim ljudima, to je više, da kažem, da bi bila jasnija slika. Kad se uradi taj bludni greh između dvoje slobodnih ljudi, zadužujemo se 20.000 u engleskoj funti kod satane.
So he says when two, he is using kind of vivid imagery for the benefit of young people. He's saying that when two people freely commit fornication, that they are actually essentially bringing themselves closer to the devil. Somehow they are, ne znam kako bi prevalo, 20.000.
They have having a loan of 20,000 quid.
They are loaning the devil 20,000 pounds, yeah.
Mortgage, yeah.
So, we have situations that somebody has, they are 5 years in connection, someone is 7, someone is 10, before marriage. And then I say, okay, for 5 years, you get about 3,500,000. For 7 years, you have a 5 million loan. And for 10 years, it's 7 million quid loan. So this we will have to pay, and with interest. Oh, this was in English. Naravno, i onda mladi ljudi kad se ožene, posle dugih takvih veza, odjednom se posveđaju i posle 6 mjeseci se razvedu. A ne znam ni šta im se desilo.
So many young people, after such relationships, when they finally do get married, after 6 months or whatever time period, they actually come into conflict and end up going their separate ways.
Zato što Satana dođe i počne da naplaćuje svoje dugove.
Because the devil has come and he is starting to reclaim his debt.
Zato je važno što kaže da naučimo, pre svega da naučimo decu od malena, da ih krstimo što pre i da idu u crkvu.
So that's why it's important to teach children from a very young age. We have to christen them and to bring them to church.
I da se pričešće.
And to partake of Holy Communion.
Ja sam se zapanjio kad sam došao ovde u Azbukavicu i kad su mi rekli da je bio običaj da decu uopšte ne pričešćuju do 7. 8. godine, zato što su kao anđeli.
Gde je Azbukavica?
Azbukavica je pored Drine.
So he, father was very shocked when he first arrived at a particular location in western Serbia because it was actually considered normal not to give communion to children until the age of 7 or 8 because they are supposedly like angels.
Baš zato što su kao anđeli dok su mali tako, znači tu se Gospod u njih useljava za ceo život.
But it's precisely because they are like angels that at a young age we should allow the Lord to actually enter them and then stay with them for their whole life.
Druga je bila isto stvar da se tu niko nije ispovedao. Meni je vladika postao jedan kut, kulturno-umetničko društvo, da ih ugostim u Grčkoj dok sam bio. I pričajući sa njima, shvatio sam da se nikad niko nije ispovedio.
So the other thing he noticed when he came to this location was that no one was actually going to confession. So when they actually visited with a, there was a kind of cultural group, I think folk dancing group. And when he visited Greece with them, he got to know them slightly better. And he realized that none of them actually confess.
And I asked the bishop, pitao sam vladiku zašto je to tako. Rekao mi da je bilo posle rata puno dožnika i u crkvi, pa da se onda preko ispovesti su mnogi ljudi uhapšeni, tako da su dobili bili blagoslov da se pričešćuju bez ispovesti.
He says the reason, he asked the local bishop, Lavrentije, for the reason why does no one actually confess. And he said it was a leftover of the times when, during communism, as far as I can understand, when the people, when they would come to confess, in some cases it was not actually a private confession, but what they had confessed would somehow be used against them by the communist state, and therefore they were given actually a blessing not to confess for a large period of communism.
Tada sam i odlučio da se vratim u Srbiju i da dođem baš na to mesto. I sad se tamo svi ispovedi.
So this was one of the motivating factors for father to return to Serbia to this precise location. And now people are confessing as they should be.
Jedan drugi greh koji je veoma bio isto kod nas implantiran kao jedan trojanski konj, to je abortus.
So another sin that was implanted amongst us like a Trojan horse, was the sin of abortion.
Nažalost, ne zna se uopšte tačan broj koliko je bilo abortusi su uključeni negde 59. godine za vreme Titove vlasti.
So, unfortunately, we don't even know, we don't even have a rough number of how many babies were aborted. This practice was actually instituted during Tito's role in 1959.
Perhaps more than 30 million children were killed by abortion from that time. And ali nije samo to, znači čak i predupređenje od bremenitosti, kao što je spirala, ona ne, kako se kaže, ne dolazi do sprečavanja začeća, nego se oplođena jajna ćelija umire od gladi ako dođe na spiralu, ako se zakači za zid materice, postaje ljudsko biće. Znači to je isto ubistvo.
And it is not just a matter of abortion, there are also various forms of contraception which are not actually preventing the baby from forming, but they are actually starving it of the nutrients it needs to survive.
Tako da u principu jedna ta spirala pravi pet abortusa na godinu.
So this is the equivalent of 5 abortions annually.
Starac Kleopa u Rumuniji je davao kaznu od 50 godina da nema pričešća za jedan abortus.
So Elder Kleopa from Romania actually gave a penitence of 50 years without Holy Communion in relation to this sin.
Pa onda je malo popuštao ako se čovjek iskreno kaje, ako počne da posti sve postove, smanji 5-6 godina, pa ako uzme akatist za tu decu ponedeljkom i da posti ponedeljkom, onda smanji još 6 godina. Pa tako je smanjivo obično do 5-6 godina, ali najmanja mu je kazna bila 5-6 godina pokajanja bez svete tajne pričešća.
And if the elder realized that the person was truly repenting and fasting, going to the various church services, he would start to lessen the penitence by 5 or 6 years to the point when it reached a total of more or less 5 or 6 years in such cases.
Ali suštinski gledano, jedan abortus je kao 50 godina nesreće na tu porodicu.
But abortion can in principle be seen as a period of 50 years of unhappiness and misfortune upon the family where it is conducted.
U Rusiji je uveden abortus odmah 1917. čim je Lenin došao na vlast.
In Russia, or what became the Soviet Union, abortion was introduced the moment the communists came to power in 1917.
Tako da ako nije bilo porodica gde bilo po 80 abortusa.
So there were some families where there were up to 80 such abortions.
80 times 50 is 4,000 years of unhappiness. Kod nas isto tako bilo. Jako mnogo, naročito posle rata, zato što su i lekari i nauka objašnjavali tim jadnim ljudima da dete nije ni živo do drugog meseca.
And there were, it was the same in Serbia or Yugoslavia at the time, partially because doctors were actually trying to claim that the baby is not even alive until the age of 2 months.
Međutim, da su čitali Evanđelje, onda bi videli da je Sveti Jovan Krstitelj, kad je bio 6 meseci star u utrobi Svete Elisavete, pozdravio Gospoda koji je bio samo 2-3 dana od začeća u utrobi Svete Bogorodice, kada je on došla da poseti Elisavetu. Elisaveta je bila bliska rođaka.
But he says if they would have actually read the Holy Gospel, they would be familiar with the fact that the Holy Forerunner John the Baptist actually greeted Christ when he was still in his mother's womb at the age of 6 months, and when actually the Virgin Mary had only been carrying Christ for a number of days.
Znači, oplođena jajna ćelija je čovjek koji ima dušu i telo i ličnost.
So what is in the womb is a man that has a soul, a body and a personhood to them.
Tako da je kriminal bilo šta činiti sa tim, sa tim.
So it is criminal to do something like this to such a creature.
U Americi se osnovalo jedno društvo i oni su rekli da su društvo za ubijanje male dece.
In America they actually went as far as creating a society which was geared towards the killing of children in their mother's womb.
So they said, oni su se osnovali sa ciljem da uzimaju male bebe i da ih iskasape što više mogu.
And so, Planned Parenthood, jel? To je ta...
Ne, da uzme...
Ili generalno društvo.
Društvo.
So, and this society has resulted in the mutilation of these children.
No, this was just an idea, but kada su svi počeli da se sablažnjavaju kako je to društvo i na što to liči, oni su pitali, a šta je abortus?
So, this was, at the start, it was just an idea, and it was something that was actually shocking. But then gradually through time it reached the kind of results that we see.
Da bi bilo jasnije, znači zakon je takav, znači ako dete izvadimo, ako izađe iz utrobe majčine i ako ga neko ubije, možda dobije 40 godina robije.
So the law is such that if once the child has come out of the mother's womb, if you kill him at that point, you will obtain a sentence of 40 years in prison.
A ako se ubija kroz abortus, nikom ništa, nikom ne odgovara.
But if you kill them, kill the child through abortion, i.e. before the mother has given birth, then no one cares.
Ali Gospod će suditi veoma strogo za takve stvari i traži veliko i veliko pokajanje. Znači, čovjek mora se kajati celog života, i muško i žensko, nije samo jedno krivo. Sa nadom da će biti oprošten.
But the Lord will judge very strictly such cases and very deep and profound repentance is required for the rest of one's life, and we are not just talking about the woman in this case, but we are talking about the man, and together they both are responsible when such a crime is committed.
Evo, preporučujemo i ove knjige Flavijana, znači oca Torika, i iz ove prve knjige Flavijan ćemo pročitati baš to. Mitarstvo, pošto se tu dešava jedna ispovest o mitarstvima i ovo je mitarstvo ubistva.
Drži mikrofon. Ovo je mikrofon.
Sad ću. Oče, kaže, a sada da se skoncentrišemo na redu mitarstvo ubistva. Oče Flavijane, nikoga nisam ubio, osim muva i komaraca, čak sam i mačku oteo od klinaca kada su hteli da je obese. Kaže, mačku si oteo, a Petar mališana, a može biti i devojčica si ubio. O čemu ti to, oče Flavijane, kakve mališane, kakve devojčice? Svoje sopstvene, rođenu decu, svojom saglašnošću na abortuse, saučestvovao si u izvršenju smrtne presude nad njima, nevinom odojčani, a dželatski posao odradio je lekar. Gospode, zar je stvarno tako? Zar je to ubistvo? Pa oni se još nisu ni rodili, zato se i nisu rodili jer su ih još u materinskoj utrobi ubili. Ima jedan dokumentarni film, zove se Nemi krik. Treba da ga pogledaš. Sam ćeš da se uveriš kada vidiš kako odojče utrobi pokušava da izbegne metalni predmet, kako otvara ustašca, zove u pomoć i kako ga zatim taj instrument kida na komade i sastrugava iz majčine utrobe. Uzgred, čak ni životinje ne rade takve stvari svojim mladuncima, samo čovjek. I onda glavni junak se ovdje onesvijesti i tako dalje.
So this is a book called Flavian, which was written by
Aleksandar Torik.
Aleksandar Torik.
Sveštenik iz Podmoskovlja.
This is a priest in Greater Moscow. Od ste počeli oče? We are reading now from this particular book. So the Lord will forgive you, Alexei. We are focusing now on the toll houses for murder. And then Alexei replies, Father Flavian, I haven't killed anyone apart from a fly and a flea or a mosquito. And I've even helped save a cat which wanted to hang itself. Father Alexei replies, the cat you have saved and five little children. But you have killed a little girl. And he replies, what do you mean, Father? Little children, which little girl? And he replies, your own children, because of your agreement that abortion should be committed, you have actually sentenced to death those creatures, those innocent creatures. And you allowed the actual doctor to commit the murderous crime. And he replied, my lord, is it really so? Is that really murder? They weren't even born yet. And he replied, well, the reason they weren't born is because you killed them in their mother's womb. And there is a documentary film which is the helpless cry, which you should watch to convince yourself and to really see how a child in the womb is actually still able to try and avoid the metal objects which are being inserted in order to kill it, how it's opening its mouth, how it's crying for help. And when that instrument of death, that metal instrument, begins to cut him into pieces within his mother's womb, and even animals don't do this to their young, only man does this.
Okay, that's it. Ovde, ovde u ovoj prvoj knjizi gdje ima ispovest po mitarstvima, koja je vrlo dobra i dobro da se pročita, jer mi ni sami nismo ni svesni što kaže koliko smo grešni i šta je sve greh.
So this book is good to read. It talks about sins, and many times we are not actually even aware of our sins or what is even a sin.
Tu su mitarstvo mnogo glagoljivosti, mitarstvo laži, mitarstvo osude, mitarstvo zavisti, mitarstvo bluda, krađe i tako dalje.
So there are many different toll houses. These are when we pass over into the next life, where we are actually being exposed for our sins, and there are many such sins, everything from lying, stealing,
laptop talking,
yes, empty talk, many different sins,
jealousy, lust, and the others. Na primjer, ako mnogo pričamo, sva naša dobra dela će da otpadnu samo na prvom mjestu, a šta će nas ostaviti?
So if we talk lots of nonsense, all of our good works will actually may not count for much even at this first toll house where we are being exposed for our empty and idle talk.
U petoj posljednjoj knjizi koja se zove Ispovijest slučajnog putnika, ima ispovijest po blaženstvima i ja mislim po molitvi Oče naš.
So in the fifth book there is a
ispovest.
There is a confession.
Po blaženstvima. Blaženi nisti duhom.
Yeah.
Ili njihovo carstvo nebeskog.
The beatitudes. Yeah. Beatitudes. Yeah.
Beatitudes. I po molitvi Oče naš po.
And for our Lord's prayer.
Tako da jako baš što toplo preporučujemo. Ove knjige su pisane onako jednostavnim jezikom, kao što je naš vladika Nikolaj pisao, da svaki Srbin može da razume.
So I warmly recommend these books because they were written in a very simple language, as was the custom of Saint Nikolai, Saint Bishop Nikolai, written in a very similar style that it's very simple to understand in Serbian.
I sitni gresi, ako se nakuplja, ako se nispovedaju, kao kad pada mečeva, naprave jedan veliki teret.
So even very small sins, if they are not confessed, the accumulation of such sins becomes a very heavy burden.
Tako da ovdje ima, može svako da nauči i onaj koji tek ulazi u crkvu, a i sveštenik. Evo, ja sam nešto vidio, meni nikad niko nije ispovedio švercovanje u tramvaju, na primjer.
So there is a lot to learn from the books, even as a priest. Father learned some interesting anecdotes. In particular, for the first time, he read about people smuggling things in public transport.
A to kog god je živeo i studirao u Beogradu, mora da upadne u taj gre.
Nisam razumio najbolje ovaj
pa kogod je studirao u Beogradu, mora bar jedan da se švercuje.
Whoever's lived in Belgrade, it would have been very difficult for him not to commit this this sin at least once.
It's not smuggling, not paid the ticket.
Švercuje, okej, yeah. Ja, bukvalno.
Znači, pokajati se znači shvatiti svoju ništavnost i grešnost, ispovediti svoje grehe, ustati protiv greha i đavola i uvek tražiti uzrok pada u sebi, a ne preko puta.
So, true repentance means getting up and not accepting the sin, truly struggling against it. Joj, zadnji deo nisam nesečan svoj.
Uvijek tražiti uzrok pada u sebi.
Okay, yeah, and always looking for the cause in the sin within yourself and not without yourself.
Znači, ako je neko upao u greh abortusa, svjesno ili nesvjesno, najbolje pokajanje će biti da rodi što više djece.
So if someone has fallen into the sin of abortion, whether they knew it was a sin at the time or not, the ideal way of overcoming this sin will actually be childbearing in abundance.
Naravno, potrebno je jako veliko i toplo pokajanje, jer ako se to svede na dva ponedeljka da otpustimo, ne vjerujem da će Gospod to oprostiti.
So, very sincere and prolonged repentance is required. It's not a matter of just fasting for 2 weeks. Father doesn't believe that with such limited and lukewarm fasting and repentance that the Lord will forgive such sins.
Ima sveštenika koji tako misle, to je bilo davno i tako dalje, i vrlo lako, što kaže, pređe preko toga. Međutim, potrebno je te ljude podsjetiti da na zaista težinu tog greha i nekako ih dovesti u stanje pokajanja.
So there are priests that deal less or view things less severely and do not consider things in such strict terms. There were always such priests and there are now. But Father considers that it is better to actually bring the sinner into an awareness of the severity of their sin in order for them to overcome it.
I da se vratimo opet na blud. Znači, rekli smo, ako dvoje mladih koji su slobodni, sad počinje takav greh, zaduže se 20.000 funti kod Satane.
So we will return to the topic of fornication, and we said that if two people of their own free will commit this sin, that they are actually borrowing 20,000 pounds from Satan.
Praktično kazna u crkvi je, znači, da im se da godinu dana da žive u pokajanju, da poste sve postove, da prinose molitve Bogu, ali da ne mogu da se pričešćuju godinu dana.
So the typical penitence for such a sin within church is for 1 year to fast and repent and to attend church, but within this period not to actually receive Holy Communion.
Ali ako je neko od tih, to dvoje bio oženjen ili u braku, onda je kazna nije bila jednu godinu, nego 25 godina. Onda znači nije 20.000 funti, nego 500.000 funti za jedan takav greh.
So it becomes even more severe if one of these individuals was married, and the sum that they're actually loaning from the devil becomes 10 times greater than if they were, one of them was, if neither of them were married.
25 times.
25 times, literal.
So these are very serious sins. Somebody comes and tells me I'm in connection with a woman who is married for 6 years. Sad ja da prevedem na srpski, znači dođe čovjek i kaže da je u vezi sa ženom koja je udata 6 godina. Pa ti si zaradio 100.000 godina, ne smiješ se pričestiš. I tako da, mislim, ljudi su potpuno nesvesni u šta upadaju.
So people in general are not conscious of what they are getting themselves into when they commit these acts.
Da bi se borili protiv bluda, što kaže, moramo da ustanemo protiv pomisli.
So the first step in fighting against the sin of fornication starts with the mental struggle and fighting against the very first thought. So this is where the battle first begins.
Znači, čovjek svaku stariju ženu treba da gleda, posmatra kao majku. Svaku mlađu kao ćerku, a svaku istih godina kao sestru.
So a man has to actually look at every older lady as if he is looking on his mother, every female that is younger than him as his daughter, and every female the same age as him as if he is looking at his sister.
I obrnuto, svaka žena tako treba, znači u starijeg čovjeka gleda kao u oca, u mlađe kao sina, a u istih godina kao brata.
And the opposite, so every woman should look upon an older man as her father against a younger male as her son and against a male of a similar age, as if she is looking at her brother.
Gospod je to doneo u Novom Zavetu. On je rekao, čak kako pomisli čovjek za ženom sa jednom bludom pomišlju, on je već se grešio.
So this is actually stated in by the Lord in the New Testament. So when Christ actually said that even if you look at a woman with such thoughts, it is the same as committing such an act. This is where it begins.
Da bi se borili sa pomislima, znači tako je sveti Ambrozije Optinski činio, čim se pojavi takav pomisao, odmah se prekrstimo, ali krst je, ako kažemo, u ime Oca i Sina i Svetoga Duha. Znači, i kažemo, ne prihvatam takve pomisle. I onda se molio, znači, kratkim molitvama, ili ako je sam za Gospodin se Hriste, pomiluj me, ili ako je u društvu drugih, prosto se Gospode, pomiluj me, za bilo kojom molitvom, i onda bi te misli nestale.
So St. Ambrose of Optina, from the Russian monastery of Optina, his approach was when every such thought entered his mind to cross himself and to declare, Lord, I don't accept this, and to read the prayer. This is how every time such a thought entered his mind, how he battled against it.
Tako i mi treba da se borimo za čim. Svaku bludnu, svaku gnevnu, svaku osuđujuću, svaku zastrašujuću pomisao, one su obično od Satana. I treba tako da se borimo protiv njih.
And this is also how we should struggle against this sin, and not only this sin, but every sin, including the sin of anger or the sin or even fearfulness. This is how we should struggle. Every time this thought enters our mind, we should throw it away from us.
Primeri pokajanja. Pre svega apostoli Petar i Pavle. Petar koji je voleo uvijek da bude prvi do Gospoda. Ne zbog neke svoje gordosti, nego zato da mu se nađe, da mu bude pri ruci. On je onda jedan put se oslonio na sebe, nije na Gospoda, rekao da se svi odreknu, ja se neću odreći, pa se tri put odrekao Gospoda.
So this is examples of repentance are St. Peter and St. Paul. St. Peter actually declared that even if everyone else renounces Christ, he will not renounce.
Ali posle se gorko pokajao, on je kad ga Gospod pogledao izašao gorko plačući. I znaju svi ikonopisci obično slikaju svetoga apostola Petra sa crvenim očima, jer je on celog života kasnije plakao zbog toga.
But St. Peter had to severely repent for not holding to this declaration. And for the rest of his life, he was actually extremely sorrowful that that was so. And actually, many of the iconographers, when they paint his icon, they actually paint him with red eyes to represent this this regret and this sorrow.
Apostle Paul bio veliki gonitelj hrišćana, jer je bio veliki farisej, njegov učitelj Gamalilo i Barnaba, prijatelji su se već bili obratili Hristu, a on je i dalje gonio hrišćana.
And St. Paul was, as a Pharisee, was a great persecutor of Christians throughout, up to the point, obviously, of his...
And his teacher, Gamalilo, and his brother, Barnaba, they were praying. Znači, njegov učitelj, jedan od najboljih učitelja u farisejstvu, Gamalilo, i apostol 70 Barnaba su se molili toplo za njegovo preobraćenje.
So his apostle Barnabas was actually praying very fervently for his conversion.
I onda se desilo čudo na putu za Damask. Pavle je oslepeo od svetlosti i viđenja i pitao je, ko si ti, Gospode?
And then the miracle occurred on the road to Damascus, where St. Paul was blinded by the light, and he could only utter, "Who are you, Lord?" He recognized it was the Lord, but he didn't know who it was.
A Gospod je rekao, ja sam onaj koga ti goniš, ne vredi ti protiv bodila praćati se.
And then the Lord said, "I am he who you persecute." Evo drugo nisam uvijek.
It's not worth it to fight against me. To je suština.
It is worth you to kick against the goats
with the. I onda se Pavle pokajao i postao je jedan od najboljih apostola.
And then St. Paul repented and actually became one of the main apostles.
Sa svojom čopavom nogom tri puta obišao ceo svet.
And with his crippled foot actually managed to cross the known world multiple times in his missionary activities.
I kaže, molio je Gospoda da odstupi taj, kaže, đavo mi se vukao u nogu i stalo mu pravio bolove, a Gospod je rekao, dosta ti je moja blagodat.
And he actually prayed to the Lord to cure him of his ailment with his foot. And the Lord actually said to him, "No, my grace is enough for you to continue the mission despite carrying this ailment."
Još jedan primjer, Sveta Marija Egipćanka, koja kao mlada upala u strast bluda.
So another example is St. Mary of Egypt, who, when she was young, fell into the sin of fornication.
Koja se ukrcala na brod hodočasnika, koji su hteli da idu u svetu zemlju, da se poklone Hristovom grobu, ali ona se nije ukrcala zato, nego da ode da još više uživa u svom grehu.
So she actually at that momentous time in point in her life actually embarked on a ship which was heading towards with pilgrims who were heading towards Jerusalem, but her intent was not to go on a pilgrimage, it was to also as a prostitute to do business there.
Ali onda se pokajala kad je videla da ne može da uđe u hram, da je nevidljiva sila brani, onda je ona okrenula se ikoni preste Bogorodice i zamolila da je dopusti da uđe u hram, da se pokloni i obećala da će se promeniti.
So at the point when she tried to enter the church, there was an invisible force which was preventing her from entering. And it was at this point that repented and she prayed in order for her to be allowed to enter the church.
I onda je posle toga otišla u pustinju sa jednom kotaricom boba i možda malo nafora.
So then after this she went straight into headed straight for the desert. With almost nothing, apart from a little bit of holy bread and some beans.
I tako ona živjela u pustinji 50 godina.
And she lived the next 50 years of her life in the desert in this fashion.
Jako je ostala bez hrane i bez vode i bez svega. Preko 20 godina se i dalje borila sa tim strastima.
She, despite the fact that she had taken no food or water with her, for the next 20 years she was fighting against the particular sin of fornication.
I još uvijek imala napade đavolske da joj se pilo vino i da joj se upadalo u te strasti.
And was still receiving temptations for the devil, amongst other things, also the attraction of drinking also was the devil was tempting her with this.
Ali posle toga, kad je sreo starac Zosima, ona je bila potpuno sveta.
But by the time she met the elder Zosim, who was another priest monk that was living in the same desert, by that point she had already cleansed herself of these sins.
I prešla je u vodu, kao što je Gospod prelazio more, tako ona prešla Jordan.
In the same way that the Lord was able to walk to cross water, she also crossed the Jordan River.
I sveti starac Zosima je uspio da je pričesti.
And the elder Zosim, actually this priest monk, communed her after this couple of decades.
Posle 50 godina.
55 decades, in fact.
I ona se onda upokojila.
And after this moment, this was when she gave her soul up.
Mnogo ljudi je dolazilo u naš manastir i to su promenili se njihovi životi i potpuno se promenila sve u njihovim životima.
So many people who have come to the monastery, it has led to a change in their lives, a complete reorientation of their lives.
Because of their repentance. Jer su se pokajali, jer su shvatili da su grešili. Tako smo primili jednog čovjeka posle zatvora, jer kod nas više nema nikakvih prihvatilišta. Kad ljudi izađu iz zatvora, odmah su na ulici, iako nemaju čega da žive, oni ponovo odmah padaju u kriminal. I da ne bi taj čovjek pao u kriminal, mi smo ga primili da bude kod nas par meseci, pa posle da ide kod svoje supruge koja je bila u inostranstvu.
So one example of this was actually a criminal which they accepted into the monastery. So in Serbia there is no real places or shelters where criminals would maybe be corrected or helped once they come out of prison, and then they fall easily into the crimes that they were committing before jail. And in order to avoid this, they accept them into the monastery for a period of a number of months before going back to unite with his wife outside of Serbia.
On se tako pokajao, tako se promenio da je postao kao jagnje.
And his repentance was so pure that it changed him. He was like a lamb.
Jedan dan je izašao u grad da nešto po nekom poslušanju i milicija ga zaustavila i tražila mu ličnu kartu. Kad su uzeli i pogledali istoriju njegovih grehova, onda su se preplašili i došli su kod mene.
So on one occasion he had been sent into town in order to run an errand, and he was stopped by the police, who asked for his identity card, and when they realized who it was, they were actually quite concerned for the father and the other monastics, and they actually came to him.
Glavni inspektor sa 3-4 policajca došli su uplašeni za moj život da mi kažu koga ima u manastiru.
So yeah, the main inspector and 4 policemen showed up afraid for father's life, trying to tell him what type of a criminal they, he had in his presence.
Ali ja sam naravno sve to znao, čovjek se ispovedio, promijenio i onda sam ja njih ovaj, utešio da nema čega da se plaše, da je čovjek sasvim sad drugi.
But Father already knew of these crimes and these sins, and he was aware that the man had already confessed them, and he was already aware that the man had changed. So it actually was a case of him trying to reassure the police officers that there was nothing to be afraid of.
I moj lični primjer. Ja sam rođen u Beogradu. Preko puta Sabodne crkve išao sam u školu koja je sada Kralj Petar, a inače se za vreme komunizma zvala Braća Ribar. Bila je prestižna škola.
And also there's my own personal example. I was born in Belgrade, opposite the main church, and I attended a school close by to this church.
Škola je stvarno bila kvalitetna i dešavalo se da odemo na neko takmičenje ovaj, i da uzmemo prva tri mesta sve iz iste škole.
The school was a very good one. There were many competitions which they were sent to compete with other children from other schools, and it wasn't unusual for the first to third place to all be taken by pupils from this school.
Ja sam bio đak generacije i nosila Vukove nagrade.
So I was the best pupil in my age group and won a certain award for this.
I dobio sam, na sreću sam dobio za nagradu Braću Karamazove od Dostojevskog.
And I was lucky to receive as a reward for winning this prize the book by Dostoevsky, The Brothers Karamazov.
Tad sam imao 15 godina, pročitao sam, ona je na mene ostavila vrlo jak utisak. Nisam mnogo razumeo, ali sam onda u toku sljedeće dve godine pročitao sva dela Dostoevskog.
So the book had a very strong impact on Father. He was only 15 years old. He didn't understand everything, but within a short period, the next few years, he'd actually read every single one of Dostoevsky's books.
Tu se i rodila ideja kod mene da je lepo kad neko može da veruje u Boga, ali mi smo bili tako ispranih mozgova da sam mislio da je to za nas nemoguće.
So he reached the stage when he thought it would be a very nice idea and a very nice thing to believe in God, but he hadn't yet reached the point when he truly believed in God. He had been so brainwashed by the society he lived in, he had not reached the stage yet.
Naravno, zbog tih svih uspeha bio sam veoma gord. I smatrao sam da me čeka ne znam ja kakva neka budućnost kao naučnika ili tako nešto.
And naturally, because of these achievements, academic achievements, he had the sin of pride, and he thought that, you know, a very illustrious path awaited him, that he would be some great scientist.
I onda sam, jako sam počeo da studiram bio u Beogradu i završio bio dve godine na Beogradskom fakultetu, odlučio da dođem na prvu godinu u Birmingham.
He finished 2 years of university in Belgrade and then for the third year decided to come to Birmingham here in England.
Zato što kod nas fakultet traje 5 godina, a u Engleskoj traje 3 godine. Mi sa naših 57 ispita, a ovde sa 25 dobijemo istu titulu.
Because in Serbia, especially during communism, university lasted so long. It lasted 5 years, and he realized he could come here and finish and get the same degree in 3 years. So this was the motivation.
Prijatelj moga oca, Zoran Ranić, koji je predavao na Politehniku u Coventriju. On me je zvao stalno da dođem, zato što je stalno pomagao nekim svojim prijateljima čiji su, čije su deca bili loši đaci, jedva su prolazili, nisu prolazili, i hteo je da dovede nekog da malo Englez vide da ima i pametni srba.
So one of his father's friends was actually lecturing in Coventry, and he asked father to attend in order to be an example to these students. They were quite poor students, and so he wanted to show them an example of an excellent student, especially from Serbia.
So I came to England. First year, I managed somehow. Prvu godinu sam nekako dao, međutim, onda sam počeo polako da padam u depresiju i u strah da neću moći da zapamtim, da neću moći da tačno naučim ono što treba.
So, when he first moved here in the beginning, it all went quite well, but shortly thereafter, he actually fell into depression. And a kind of fear that he would not actually fulfill his potential.
U to vreme nisam još bio ni kršten, tako da nisam imao nikakvu pomoć.
So he was not yet christened at this time, and so he had no help in this sense.
Tako da sam, počeo da mi napadaju i samoubilačke pomisli.
So he was even beginning to receive suicidal thoughts.
Moji roditelji su osetili da nešto nije u redu i onda su me zvali da se vratim.
And his parents realized something was not quite right and they asked him to return to Serbia.
I ja sam se vratio i nastavio sam tamo gde sam bio stao. I to sam u roku završio. Tim sam se vratio u Srbiju, izašao sam iz depresije u roku od nedelju dana.
And as soon as he returned to Serbia, he had the depression stopped within a week, and he managed to actually sit all of his exams.
Kasnije sam shvatio da Gospod daje depresiju kao lek za gordost.
And then later he realized that the Lord sends depression as a cure for the sin of pride.
Zato što ako se oslanjamo samo na sebe, onda što kaže dolazimo u tu kategoriju da živimo u ovom okviru koji nam se prikazuje preko ovih sokočela i da živimo, da jedemo, spavamo, da se razmnožavamo i da plaćamo račune.
So if we get to the stage where we just rely upon ourselves for everything and not on God, our life becomes just about very empty things, which such as paying bills, eating, working, but without an inspirational motive for life.
Kasnije sam završio fakultet. Još uvek nisam bio kršten, još ženio se.
So, but I finished university, and but father had not yet got married or been christened, in fact.
Da, samo smo se venčali u opštini, ali nismo mogli u crkvi, jer sam bio nekršten. I dobili smo troje dece za tri godine.
So father had not actually got married in church, but he had a legal marriage, and he already had three children by this point.
In the first 3 years.
I počeli su problemi u braku, jer kad smo nevenčani, onda đavo sme da nas tuče, zato što živimo u grehu.
And the problem started with his wife, and father says that when we are living without outside of the confines of marriage, then the devil actually has a kind of right over us to torment us and to sow the seeds of disunity.
So we applied for Canada, not because of material things, but it was a bad time in Serbia and Yugoslavia. Our salaries was about 100 Deutschmarks. My wife, she was a lawyer for a company. I was an engineer, so we had 200 Deutschmarks. And the apartment that we paid was 300 marks. but this was not the reason why we went to Canada. The reason was I believed that our marriage would improve over there. Sad na srpskom. Znači, živjeli smo u loše vreme sa platama od 100 maraka, a stan je koštao 300 maraka. Onda sve ostalo je moralo se zaradi sa ekstra radom posle podne. Tako da sam nekad radio po 16 i 18 sati dnevno. Ali nismo zbog toga otišli u Kanadu, otišli smo jer sam se ja nadao da ćemo tamo popraviti naše odnose. To sam već rekao. Međutim, desilo se baš suprotno i tu sam naučio tu lekciju da ne treba nigde da se ide daleko da bi se rešio problem. Problem treba da rešimo tu gde smo. I naša bračna zajednica se raspala posle 7-8 meseci. Moj sin se razboleo, dobio epilepsiju posle mesec dana od toga. I to je bilo moje drugo umiranje. Prvo umiranje je bilo u Birminghamu, a ovde, što kaže, ali to je sve bilo potrebno da bi se potpuno oslobodio svake gordosti.
So after around 7 months of being in Canada, even though the intention had been to give a new impetus and cure the and improve the relationship with his wife and within the family, it was the complete opposite. So after 7 months, the marriage fell apart. His son also got epilepsy. And he realized that it was a necessary lesson for him. And one of the things that he realized was that you should not go elsewhere in order to try and solve the problems that you're encountering. It's not the place or the location which will be the cure, but you have to fight to resolve these problems where you are already located.
Verovatno da ne bi preživao sve to, da se nisam onda prilepio crkvi. Našao se jedan grčki manastir koji je imao službu svaki dan i onda sam ja išao svako jutro i svako večer u taj manastir.
So, and this was like a second death for him. I forgot to translate this the last time. This was like a second death for him. The first death being when he was in Birmingham in the stage of depression. And he says that he was very emotional by nature, and if he hadn't of actually encountered and found the church, who knows what would have happened to him. But he had he was able to actually visit a Greek monastery he was attending at this point. He started attending multiple times a week the divine services.
I pošto sam bio i pojac u Beogradu u Vavedenju, gde sam bio i kršten od vladike Atanasija, koji je tada bio jeromonak. Tako sam i u tom manastiru počeo da pojem bizantijsko pojenje.
And he actually, early in his life, even before he was christened, he had begun actually singing in church and had some kind of talent for this church singing, and he continued this in this Greek monastery in the Byzantine style. He was learning how to chant, in fact, is the word.
I dobio sam posao janitora, nastavnika, i dobro mi je došao taj posao, jer sam bio samostalan u radu, I mogao sam da idem u crkvu svaki put kad je trebalo.
So he was lucky to get the job as a caretaker, which gave him a certain kind of independence, which allowed him to go to church, go to this monastery whenever he wanted.
I onda su sami vladika predložio da me rukopolože za đakona u jednom trenutku. Međutim, nije došlo do toga, pa sam kasnije rukopoložen u jednom drugom sinodu.
So the bishop at the time actually suggested that he be ordained a deacon, although this didn't come to pass at that particular point, but he was later ordained in another location, another church.
Nisam mogao odmah da se vratim. Moja želja je bila da možda odem i na Svetu Goru, ali su deca bila mala i vidio sam da sam im potreban, pa sam ostao tu 10 godina.
So his actual desire was to go to the holy mountain, Mount Athos, but because his children were still very young at the time and he realized that they needed him, he decided to stay with them for the next 10 years.
A posle toga vratio sam se prvo u Srbiju i došao kod vladike Lavrentija i on me prihvatio da budem kod njega u eparhiji, ali mi dao blagoslov da odem u Grčku.
So after this 10 years, he returned to Serbia to Bishop Lavrentije, and he stayed with him for a while, but he got the blessing to actually go to Greece.
I posle 3 godine u Grčkoj, onda su došli ta deca iz Ljubovije i s njima sam pričao, ispovedao ih, poučavao. I onda su oni otišli kod vladike i molili vladiku da me dovede u Srbiju.
So what happened was after 3 years in Greece, this was when the folk dancing group visited from Ljubovija, which is the location where Bishop Lavrentije is the bishop. And when he spent time with these young people and he actually confessed them, when they went back to their hometown, they actually begged the bishops to bring father from Greece to make him come back to Serbia.
I tako sam shvatio da Gospod dopustio da prođem kroz mnoge te situacije, da bi mogao da shvatim o čemu ljudi pričaju kad dođu.
And he realized that the reason that God allowed him to experience these situations and this pain was so that he would understand people when they confessed to him.
I onda sam se prešao i rekao pred Veljom Pavlovićem da mnogi nemaju vremena za ljude, a ja se trudim da imam, i onda je došla cela Srbija.
So he says many people say they don't have time for people, but he tried to be open and to accept everyone, and then the whole of Serbia is descended upon his monastery.
Tako sam ja i ovde danas kod vas.
And for that reason I'm with you here today as well.
Eto, to je bilo što sam imao da ispričam večeras. A sad ako hoćete da napravimo malu pauzu, pa ako ima nekih pitanja, ili ne znam da smo vreme, da smo probušili vremenske barijere.
Dostojno jest Jakovo istinu, blažiti tja Bogorodicu, prisno blaženuju i preneporočnuju, i Mater Boga našego, čestnjejšuju heruvim i slavnjejšuju, besravnjeni ja serafim, bezizljenija Boga, slova rošuju, sušuju, Bogorodicu tja veliša.
Gospodi pomiluj, Gospodi pomiluj, Gospodi pomiluj, Oče blagoslovi.
Molite vama svetih otaca naših, Gospodi sve Hriste Bože naš, pomiluj nas.
Amin.
Hvala na vašoj ljubavi. Amin.